I hear the secrets that you keep when you're talking in your sleep. All your dreams that you keep inside, you're telling me the secrets you just can't hide. Or maybe you're just saying nonsense words or something, I don't know. Hey there, sleepers, Trace here for DNews, thanks for tuning in. Somniloquy is the name given to the sleep abnormality of talking in your sleep. For some unknown reason, some people will snooze comfortably and quietly, whereas others will speak gibberish, words, sentences, or entire speeches whilst sawing their logs. Understanding somniloquy involves understanding a bit about sleep first. As you fall asleep, your brain's reticular activating system, RAS, hands control over to the ventrolateral preoptic nucleus, or VLPO, for sleepy time. During that transition is when you do the little twitching things. We did a whole video about that, check it out. Once asleep, the brain goes through a predictable set of four stages. One of those is the famous rapid eye movement, where dreaming happens. And during sleep, your brain squirts out two paralyzing chemicals, glycine and GABA. These keep your vocal cords and your mouth and your body and your muscles and such paralyzed. Okay, so. Scientists don't have any idea why some people talk in their sleep. Sleep talking can occur at any time, during REM or non-REM sleep, which means it's not necessarily when we voice a dream, it can be any time. Scientists think sometimes people might slip through their own paralyzing net of glycine and GABA and end up voicing what's happening inside their head, called a motor breakthrough. Or maybe it's because of transitory arousal, which is another theory, and that's when we're switching between sleep stages. We might end up talking. Sleep talking is related to sleepwalking and night terrors, and about half of all children and 5% of adults will talk in their sleep. It's more common among men than women, although sleep researchers really don't know why. Sleep talking is hardly ever sensical. Sometimes it's a few words, sometimes it's 30 seconds or more. Sometimes sleep talkers are sweet, sometimes they're explicit, sometimes they whisper, and sometimes they shout. And that's where it can turn into a problem for those sharing a bedroom with others. A study of over 2,000 school children published in the journal Brain and Development found only 10% of children will sleep talk every night, but 50% will do so once a year. According to another study in pediatrics, by age 13, most childhood sleep abnormalities declined, but not somniloquy. The problem with most sleep studies is we don't remember talking in our sleep because we're asleep. And even when we're sharing a bed, instances are so brief the other sleeping person commonly misses it too, unless there's persistent conversation, which is possible. Look up Sleep Talkin' Man for some entertaining sleep talking, super funny. Other than the possibility of waking up your bedfellow or your roommate, sleep talking isn't generally harmful. Though, when people frequently experience somniloquy after age 25, the National Sleep Foundation recommends seeking professional help. Somniloquy is not connected to insanity or anything, as it's portrayed in films and stories sometimes, but simply stress. The National Sleep Foundation says adult somniloquy can be brought on by stress, fever, sleep deprivation, alcohol or drugs, or something more serious, like depression. Psychology Today advises partners who are having trouble sleeping because of somebody sleep talking around them to invest in a fan, white noise machine, or good earplugs if it's causing interruption. But rest assured that you will rest assured soon. Often the behavior is short-lived, either during a period of waking high stress, poor sleep, or when they're kids, just being kids. Practicing healthy sleep behaviors, limiting caffeine and screens before bed, and keeping a regular bed and wake time all decrease instances of sleep talking in adults. Oh, and if you are for some reason worried about spilling your secrets, courts have ruled talking in your sleep is inadmissible as evidence, as it is not the product of a conscious mind. So sleep soundly, criminal friends. Have you ever experienced somniloquy, either as a talker or the woken up partner? Let me know down in the comments. Be sure you subscribe for more DNews, and for more on sleep, check out this great video from a handsome devil about how sleeping pills don't actually help you sleep that good. Most of the newest drugs will allow the brain into REM sleep, but they don't allow the brain to go through the full process, which means the brain doesn't have a chance to clean up and process memories from the day before, cementing them for future reference. Thanks for watching DNews, everybody. We'll see you next time.